Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a bunch of information for this video, starting with a tweet from Michael Sheets. He asked Elon Musk, is SpaceX spending much time or money refurbishing the Falcon 9 boosters between launches, or is it just cleaning and inspection still? I know 10 reflights was the expected milestone for needing significant refurbishment. Musk responded with, work needed between flights is less and less as shown by shortening time between reflights. Required work between flights for Starship and Super Heavy is zero. Regan Beck, who lives near Boca Chica I believe, posted some shots of a Falcon 9 booster doing a static fire at the facility. She posted it saying, Falcon 9 first stage booster 1069. There are claims that SpaceX discriminates in its hiring process, and this Bloomberg article was posted recently in relation to that. It says, Elon Musk's SpaceX must turn over hiring records sought by the US Justice Department as part of its probe into whether the company discriminates against job seekers based on their citizenship status, a federal judge ruled. Here's a view of the orbital launch site construction progress over in Boca Chica. Early in the morning on Thursday, SpaceX stacked the 7th level of the vehicle integration tower. The 8th and final launch tower segment is currently under construction. Here's a view of the cryotank shells 2 at the propellant production site. Here's a look at the unknown structure near the propellant production site. 3 Raptor engines were spotted recently delivered to Boca Chica. A Starship aft section and Super Heavy upper section were mated, likely for stage separation testing. Here's a view of a nose cone and nose cone barrel section sitting outside, possibly for ship 20. Thomas Burghart posted a tweet captioning a picture Chris B posted of a Raptor boost engine in Boca Chica. He said, a Raptor boost engine has been spotted in Boca Chica for the first time. This is a non-gimbling, non-throttling, higher thrust version of Raptor for Super Heavy. Musk responded with, outer engine ring is fixed angle but can throttle. Musk was asked a question on Twitter in regards to Starship. It says, how far into the future might we see 18 meter variants undergo construction, or is it simply no longer in the plans due to the sheer difficulty it would take to build and fly? Musk responded with, once you have rapidly reusable rockets of sufficient size to carry over 100 tons of payload, it is not clear that cost per ton to orbit Moon or Mars improves significantly with a larger rocket. Aircraft, for example, have moved away from the 747 A380 to 777, which has approximately 100 tons of payload. In response to a tweet from Everyday Astronaut on the video of Falcon 9 returning to LZ1, Musk gave some more Starship information. He said, great shot, by the way, Starship Super Heavy will not have an entry burn. Delta V is shifted more to the ship, so booster entry Q and heating is lower. Everyday Astronaut responded to that tweet by posting, with more Delta V being on the upper stage, isn't mass fraction even more important than ever on Starship and even less important on Super Heavy? I'm surprised to see so much focus on Super Heavy weight reduction when it's most important on Starship. Musk responded and said, we've already done a lot of iteration on ship. For rapid reusability, booster must return to launch pad, so inert mass impacts ascent, boost back and landing burns. Triple whammy. Also, booster flight rate is approximately 5 times that of ships, and multiply mass dollar cost by 5. Musk was also asked, will the first orbital Super Heavy have grid fins? Elon Musk responded with, first one to fly will, so booster 4. Booster 3 will be used for ground tests. We are changing much of design from 3 to 4. Expect especially rapid evolution in first approximately 10 boosters and first approximately 30 ships. Michael Baylor posted a tweet captioning what Elon Musk posted in the previous tweet. He said, missed this earlier, but Elon used the new naming conventions in his tweet and confirmed that the booster in the high bay is in fact called Booster 3. In response to his own tweet, he also posted, here are the current naming conventions as I understand them. Ship number or S number, booster number or B number, Raptor center number or RC number, Raptor boost number or RB number, Raptor vacuum number or RVAC number. Serial number stuff is out. It's been a long while since we had a proper Starship presentation from Elon Musk. Somebody asked him on Twitter, "Alright Elon Musk, where's my Starship presentation? We've been waiting almost 2 years and given we are getting close to the orbital flight, I believe it's warranted." He said, "Fair enough." Musk was asked, "Outside of Starlink, which you have changed orbit to lessen the impact Kessler syndrome, has SpaceX thought of any way to try to eventually collect space debris, since it could directly affect its business in future if it gets out of control?" He responded with, "Yes, we can fly Starship around space and chomp up debris with the moving fairing door. A new GSE upper dome stack was sleeved with the bulkhead recently. The common dome section for Ship 20 was recently lifted into the high bay." Musk posted a tweet early in the morning on Thursday with this awesome picture saying, "Super Heavy moves tomorrow." Lo and behold, later in the day on Thursday, Super Heavy Booster 3 rolled out to the launch site. Booster 3 was then lifted onto the suborbital pad A launch and test mount. Musk posted two cool pictures on Twitter of Super Heavy Booster 3 rolling out and the 7th integration tower segment stacked. In relation to the rollout of Booster 3, somebody posted a tweet saying, "I still can't believe it. Starship has unused volume for people and payload. Super Heavy is way bigger than Starship and it's all fuel." Musk responded and said, "Actually, it's almost 80% liquid oxygen." The final thing to show in our Sunday video, as always, we have the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. Like usual, I have to thank Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out in Boca Chica filming the amazing Starship content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.